If you want to convert your document like I have here on the product Yummy Bears into a PowerPoint presentation or the program PowerPoint, okay, if you don't know what it is, then you want to watch my training videos on it. But in short, PowerPoint is a presentational program. I mean, it does a lot of the same things that Word does in that you can type in text, insert images, objects, also draw shapes. But the biggest difference is that once you do all that in PowerPoint, you can actually animate any of that. So if I have the title or the heading in PowerPoint, Yummy Bears, I could select it, apply some animation, so when I give the presentation, it can fly in, zoom in, whatever animated effect I want to give it. Not only that, but in PowerPoint, you can insert movies and audio. And new to PowerPoint 2010 is that once you insert the movies and audio, you can actually edit it. So if it's an 8-minute movie, you can crop it down to, well, as small as you want, you know, 2-3 minutes, you choose. You can actually bookmark them as well. So if you have a 5-minute movie and you think that you might not be able to get through it in your presentation, you can go ahead and bookmark it, like let's say at the 4-minute mark. So that way if you are running out of time during the presentation, you can just go right to that bookmark and it'll play the last minute of the 5-minute video. Kind of cool. In any case, we already have the text that we want to give the presentation on. We just want to go ahead and convert it over into PowerPoint so we can spiff it up, add some animation, maybe insert some pictures, some transitional effects. In any case, you want to watch the training videos on that, but to get it over, I'm going to go ahead and use the Send to PowerPoint feature. Now, when I send this over into PowerPoint, you need to know is that it's not going to take all the text. It's only going to take the text, like bullet points, and the text that have the heading styles applied to it. Like you can see up here, when I have my cursor flashing, in Yummy Bears, it has the Heading 1 style applied to it. When I come down here to Flavors, it has the Heading 2 style applied to it. As you recall in the earlier training videos on styles, we talked about that later on when it comes to using some more advanced features in Word, and this is one of them. It's only going to look for, and in this case pull over, the text that have the style headings applied to it that you see up here in the Styles group, not the ones that you create. So if I come down here and I select this text and I go, okay, that's bold, and the size is now 16, that's a heading to me. It is to you, but not to Word when it comes to using the advanced features, so don't do that. Let's go ahead and undo that. That doesn't mean that you're stuck with the default heading formats that they have applied to, well, the Heading 1 style here, like B for bold and the size 16. As you recall my styles training video, you can come up here and right-click on Heading 1, modify it, and say, for all my Heading 1s, I want it to be size, you know, 26. You can make the changes here. In any case, let me click Cancel. So assuming that you watched that training video on it, just know that when we send this over to PowerPoint, it's only going to pull over the main points that have, well, the heading styles applied to it, heading 1, 2, or 3 from the styles group, and the bulleted points. Now, why would it do that and not pull over all the text? Well, the reason why it doesn't is because that's the whole purpose of the PowerPoint presentation, not to read. Can you imagine how boring that would be if you had nothing but text up on the screen there that everybody had to read and read and read and read? That's annoying. Instead, you just want to go ahead and bag the PowerPoint presentation and just print this off and hand them the handouts. Let them read it in their own time. So there we go, we've got our headings, we've got some bulleted points that'll pull those over. In fact, let me drive the point home before we convert this over into PowerPoint. I'm going to hold down the keys Control F to bring up the navigation pane. And as you recall, when we bring it up, it has three tabs. The first tab shows all the headings within the document. Well, the headings that have the heading styles up here, the defaults, 1, 2, 3, 4 or more. Okay. So can you imagine giving a presentation by having people looking at the main points and just going, okay, Yummy Bears, and you say, well, that's our product. We have special flavors, blueberry, raspberry, well, coconut, maple syrup, and our target audience is adults. Now, that's a lot simpler, and that's what PowerPoint is, than just coming over here and saying, okay, read through that. Annoying. Not only that, but in PowerPoint, once you have the titles over there, you know, for your heading ones will be titles of each slide, like Yummy Bears, you can actually, with the rest of the slide, insert some images, movies, audio, you know, make it really fun, okay? Of course, you can click to jump right to it in Word. In any case, let's close out of it. Let's go ahead and send this over to PowerPoint by coming up here. It's not on the ribbon, so we have to customize our quick access toolbar by giving it a right click, going down to customize, and then changing it from popular to all commands. And it is alphabetized, so scroll down to the S's here. And there it is, send to Microsoft PowerPoint. Go ahead and double click on it so it adds it over to the rest of the commands that are already displayed on the quick access toolbar. You know, save, save as, click okie dokie, and there it is. Go ahead and click on it, and boom, it's done. There you go. Okay, let's see what it brought over. So for the title on each slide, let me go back to the document here, it's going to be the Heading 1. So whatever you want as the title for that slide, have it in the Heading 1 style. Okay, let's go back to the presentation here. So we have Yummy Bears as the heading 1, and then any subheadings like heading 2, heading 3 will be a bulleted point to the main heading or heading 1 in the hierarchical structure. So there's heading 1 that it pulled over, and it brought over heading 2, but because that's a subheading to heading 1, well, it put it as a bulleted point under Yummy Bears, okay? And then notice how when I go to the other slides here, coconut, maple syrup, and chocolate, when I go back to my Word document here, there's coconut, maple syrup, and chocolate. It doesn't have to be in a heading style because Microsoft considers that, those bulleted points, as points to discuss. If it's bulleted over here in Word, it'll actually pull them over into the PowerPoint presentation as something that's being important. Now, you may not think it's something that you want to talk about, so you can go ahead and delete the slides. And then notice on the chocolate slide, so it had the bulleted point chocolate, but then it had back in the Word document, target audience, heading 2 as a subpoint to a bullet point. Well, it's not perfect, so if you want to go back to the presentation, make some changes there, and take target audience and have it as the heading of its own slide, or just delete it altogether, that's fine. Then there's snickerdoodles. So we have heading 1, right? Snickerdoodles. There's heading 2, oversight or overbite. So that's heading 2, a subheading to heading 1. And then you have heading 3, which is a subheading to the subheading of heading 1. So you have heading 1, the bullet, and then the sub-bullets. And if we go back to our document, let's scroll down to the bottom. There's heading 1, there's heading 2, there's heading 3. And it was able to pick that up and convert it in a way that I think is pretty helpful when it comes to bringing that over into PowerPoint. But if not, it brought over the main points. Go ahead and make any changes that you want to and add the images, clean it up, and when you're done, be sure to save your work. Thanks for watching. Hey, as a quick reminder, if you like my video, please give it a thumbs up. You can also click on me and subscribe to my channel to get notified of the latest videos. And for great specials on my products, please see the description below this video.